हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, इन सेकेंड पार्ट ऑफ दिस मैथमेटिकल फिजिक्स आई विल डिस्कस अबाउट डिफरेंशिएशन एंड इंटीग्रेशन। बिफोर डिस्कसिंग द डिफरेंशिएशन एंड इंटीग्रेशन यू हैव टू नो सम जनरल थिंग्स। दीज आर कॉन्स्टेंट्स। कॉन्स्टेंट्स आर दोज क्वांटिटीज हुज वैल्यूज आर फिक्स्ड। दे आर जनरली रिप्रेजेंटेड बाई ए बी सी ईटीसी, एग्जाम्पल 1, 2, 3 एंड सो ऑन, पाई ई, दे ऑल आर कॉन्स्टेंट क्वांटिटीज। सेकेंड आर वेरिएबल क्वांटिटीज। वेरिएबल क्वांटिटीज आर दोज क्वांटिटीज हुज वैल्यूज आर नॉट फिक्स, दे रिमेन चेंजिंग। दे आर जनरली रिप्रेजेंटेड बाई एक्स वाई जेड ईटीसी, एग्जाम्पल जी मीन्स एक्सीलरेशन ड्यू टू ग्रेविटी। As we know, acceleration due to gravity at different points on earth is different. Velocity in accelerated motion. If we throw a ball upwards, then its velocity changes at each point. Next is function. If a variable quantity y depends on other variable quantity x, then y is a function of x. And it is written as y is equal to fx. The value of function fx at x is equal to a is obtained as, we can look here upon an example, fx is equal to x square plus 2 is any function, and we want to obtain the value of this function at x is equal to 1. Then we will substitute 1 in place of x here in this equation, and we can obtain the value of function fx at x is equal to 1 as fx is equal to 1 square plus 2, 1 in place of x, then it will be 3. Also at x is equal to 2, the value of function fx is equal to 2 square plus 2 is equal to 6. Similarly, we can obtain the value of function at x is equal to 3, x is equal to 4 and so on. You can easily notice one thing, that the value of this function fx at different points is different. Now we come to our main topic, that is differentiation. If y is a function of variable x, then mathematically it is written as y is equal to fx. The value of y depends upon variable x. If the variable x is changed to x plus delta x, where delta x is a small quantity, then function y will also change from y to y plus delta y. Here y plus delta y is equal to f x plus delta x. This will be equation number 2. We will subtract equation 1 from equation 2. So we get y plus delta y minus y is equal to f x plus delta x minus fx. We will solve this equation, we get delta y is equal to fx plus delta x minus fx. Dividing both sides of this equation by delta x, we get delta y by delta x is equal to fx plus delta x minus fx upon delta x. Now I have told you here that the quantity delta x is small, so taking limits on both sides when delta x tends to 0 means delta x is small, it is tending to 0. We have limit delta x tending to 0 delta y by delta x is equal to limit delta x tending to 0 f x plus delta x minus fx upon delta x. In calculus, this quantity limit delta x tending to 0 delta y by delta x is written as dy by dx and is called the differential coefficient of function y with respect to x. Therefore, in this equation, in place of limit delta x tending to 0 delta y by delta x, we can write dy by dx is equal to limit delta x tending to 0 f x plus delta x minus fx upon delta x. This is known as differential coefficient of y with respect to x, some formulae of differentiation. Here are few very important formulas of differentiation. We will use them in different places in physics to solve our problems. First is the y is equal to c, then differential of constant with respect to x or any variable is equal to 0. If y is equal to a into fx, here fx is function and a is a constant quantity, so the differential coefficient of a constant and a function is always written as a dot differential of fx with respect to x. The constant term is taken out of the differentiation. Here next is y is equal to f1x plus minus f2x. In this case dy by dx is equal to differential of f1x with respect to x plus minus differential of f2x with respect to x. Here are few more important relations of differential calculus. First is, if y is equal to x to the power n, where n is a constant, then differential coefficient of x to the power n with respect to x is n x to the power n minus 1. Next is, if y is equal to e to the power x, its differential coefficient is e to the power x. If y is equal to a to the power x, where a is constant, then differential coefficient of a to the power x with respect to x is a to the power x log a base e. If y is equal to log x base e, then differential coefficient of log x base e with respect to x is 1 by x. If y is equal to log x base a, where a is constant, then differential coefficient of log x base a with respect to x is 1 by x into log e base a. Next is, differential coefficient of sin x with respect to x is cos x. Cos x is minus sin x. Tan x is sec square x. Differential coefficient of cot x with respect to x is minus cosec square x. Sec x is sec x tan x. Cosec x is minus cosec x into cot x. Next is, if y is equal to f1x into f2x, means the function is the product of two functions, then we consider f1 to be first and f2 to be the second function. So its differential coefficient with respect to x is first function differential coefficient of second function plus second function differential coefficient of first function. If y is equal to f1x upon f2x, then its differential coefficient with respect to x is equal to, here we write f2x whole square in denominator and in numerator, f2x differential coefficient of f1x minus f1x differential coefficient of f2x. Differential coefficient of a function means if u is equal to ft and t is equal to fx. If we want to obtain the differential coefficient of u with respect to x, then we write du by dx is equal to du by dt into dt by dx. We obtain du by dt from here and dt by dx from here. When we multiply them, we obtain du by dx. These are relations which are frequently used in physics, and some of them I have marked on previous page, that are 1, 2 and 3, and here 4, 5, 7 and 2 equations of 9, and this 10 number, this you have to remember every time. Now we will consider some examples. If y is equal to x to the power 5, then obtain the differential coefficient of y with respect to x. So dy by dx is equal to d dx x to the power 5. This is a function of the form given here in 4. Here the differential coefficient of x to the power n with respect to x is n x to the power n minus 1. So here we will apply same formula. In place of n in this equation, here is 5. So n x to the power n minus 1, 5 x to the power 4 will be the answer. Next is y is equal to sin x plus tan x. Differential coefficient of y with respect to x is equal to differential coefficient of sin x with respect to x plus differential coefficient of tan x with respect to x. Differential coefficient of sin x with respect to x is cos x, and differential coefficient of tan x with respect to x is sec square x. So this will become cos x plus sec square x. Next is y is equal to a sin omega t. This is a equation of simple harmonic motion. If a particle is executing simple harmonic motion, then its displacement equation is given as y is equal to a sin omega t. Its differential coefficient with respect to t is equal to a differential coefficient of sin omega t with respect to t. Here I have taken a out of the differentiation because a is constant, that is amplitude of the motion. Now differential coefficient of sin omega t is cos omega t. Here again we have omega t, so this will be again differentiated with respect to t. Here omega is constant, omega taken out of the differentiation. Here we get dt by dt. The value of dt by dt will become 1. So we get a omega cos omega t. Next we will discuss integration. Integration is the reverse process of differentiation. In differentiation we calculate the differential coefficient of a given function. In integration we calculate those functions whose differential coefficient is a given function. For example, there is a function fx, its differential coefficient dfx by dx is equal to f dash x. Now if we integrate this function f dash x with respect to dx, then we will obtain fx. It is written as integral f dash x dx is equal to fx. Here this is the symbol of integration. Now if this function is fx plus c, where c is an arbitrary constant, then in that case differential coefficient of the function with respect to x is equal to f dash x, because differential of constant term is 0. Now if we integrate this function with respect to x, then in that case we must get fx plus c. So something is missing here, and that is this constant. The constant term here is 0, but here is not 0. So we write this equation as integral f dash x dx is equal to fx plus c. Here c is the constant of integration, and its value can be obtained by applying boundary conditions. The constant of integration is not used unless there is an appropriate reason to use it. Here are some standard formulae of integration. Number 1, x to the power n dx is equal to x to the power n plus 1 upon n plus 1 plus c. Here the value of n is not equal to minus 1. We have to remember this thing. If n is minus 1, then there is other relation. Integral 1 upon x dx is equal to log x base e plus c. इंटीग्रल ए टू द पावर x विद रिस्पेक्ट टू dx इज इक्वल टू ए टू द पावर x अपॉन log a बाय c प्लस c, इंटीग्रल e टू द पावर x dx इज इक्वल टू e टू द पावर x प्लस c. यू कैन नोटिस दैट इफ दिस कांस्टेंट इज जीरो देन द डिफरेंशियल एंड इंटीग्रल ऑफ e टू द पावर x इज सेम. हियर दीज आर थ्री वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट रिलेशंस, this relation and this relation, which you have to definitely remember. Here are few more important relations of integration, and out of them I have marked some of them which are frequently used in physics, like integral of sin x minus cos ax plus c, integral of cos x is sin x plus c, and so on. Integral of a fx dx is equal to a integral fx dx plus c. Here a is constant, so it is taken outside of the integration. Also integral of fx plus minus gx dx is integral fx dx plus integral gx dx plus c. Next is integral sin ax dx is equal to minus cos ax upon a plus c. Next is integral cos ax dx is equal to sin ax upon a plus c. So at least you have to learn the relations which are marked here, but write down all of them on your copies. Next is definite integration. If the integration of a function fx with respect to x is capital Fx and the value of x changes from a to b, then the value of fx is fb minus fa. This difference fb minus fa of the function fx is known as definite integration for interval a to b. It is written as integral a to b fx dx is equal to capital Fx square bracket lower limit upper limit. This is solved by substituting upper limit in place of variable minus lower limit in place of variable. We will make it clear with the help of examples. First, integrate 20x to the power 5 with respect to x. Integration 20x to the power 5 dx is equal to, here 20 is constant, then according to this relation we will take 20 out of the integration, 20 integration x to the power 5 dx. Now we will use the formula x to the power n dx. This I have discussed on previous page. This is equal to x to the power n plus 1 upon n plus 1. Here in this case n is equal to 5, so we will integrate it as 20 x to the power 5 plus 1 upon 5 plus 1 is equal to 20 x to the power 6 upon 6. We can write this 10 by 3 x to the power. Now we will consider another example of definite integration. Integrate sin x dx lower limit 0 upper limit pi by 4. Except these limits, all the process of integration is done as it is explained before. The integration of sin x, as we know from this relation, is minus cos x. This will be minus cos x. Then we put here a square bracket, lower limit and upper limit. Now we have to solve this limit. What will we do? Here the variable quantity is x. In place of this variable, we will first substitute upper limit minus, then we substitute lower limit here. Then we solve it. Cos pi by 4 is 1 by root 2 and cos 0 is 1. So on solving, we get 2 minus root 2 upon 2. In this way, we can solve other examples also.